Okay, what about some of the other manufacturers, Honda, Yamaha? Is it a bit sad for you to see some of these guys struggling as they are?
I can't imagine being them.
Brad, do you think KTM can still win this championship?
I'm not drooling myself out of this.
The hills are alive. Welcome along to MotoGP Guru for the Austrian Grand Prix of 2023. It's round 10 of 20, so it's the halfway point of the season this year. A lot's happened already. There's a lot still to come. But just before that, don't forget to get all your predictions in right here, right now, on MotoGPGuru.com. It's as simple as this. All that's required is to enter with your email address and password or with your social media accounts. And boom, we're in. Here you are then. This is where you make all your predictions for the weekend ahead. And there's plenty of incredible, as you can see for yourself, cash prizes, which will be handed out without doubt across every single race weekend. And just for signing up, you're entered into a draw to possibly win this incredible Gresini-liveried Ducati Panigale V4S. So watch out for Julie Andrews in Austria. I wonder what's happening over in Oxford, though, with Mr. Nick Harris. It's a spectacular place, isn't it? I can't believe, though, we're only halfway through at the end of this weekend. There's so many races over the next few months.
I thought you meant Oxford was a spectacular place.
Well, it is, actually. Yeah, it is.
Yeah. But the Red Bull Ring is absolutely fantastic. Beautiful scenery, brilliant racetrack, an atmosphere as good as anywhere you go all season. And it's KTM country. It really is KTM country. And the support that the Austrian fans give to KTM, and rightly so, is fantastic. It makes it a really good event. The only thing can be, just like Silverstone, the weather could be a bit dodgy.
Talking of complicated rides in Austria, Mr. Brad Binder knows all about leaving slick tyres on a very, very wet surface when he won spectacularly in 2021. And he's with us now from his home in Andorra. Brad, last time you were with us, it was the Mugello weekend, wasn't it? And you sort of bet on yourself and it didn't really pay off. So maybe you can predict a load of Ducati success this weekend.
Well, you know, I think there's no chance of that happening. But anyway, I think I definitely backed myself last time in Ducati country and they came out on top. So I'm going to back myself probably again, as I always do, at KTM home round, and hopefully that pays off.
Okay, well, let's get our first predictions in, gentlemen, and let's start with qualifying. I'm going to wait for a second. I've got it. I'm not going to change it, I promise. Brad, we're going to you first. Who's going to be on pole position? It's going to be a KTM, isn't it, surely?
I'd love to say myself, but honestly, my qualifying... My qualifying, history should we say, is not quite up to scratch. And if I had to say somebody at the moment, I'd love to go with the KTM, but I think my team did an insane job in qualifying last year. So I think you'd be the favorite for pole at the moment.
Okay.
There you are,
okay.
Brad. See, experts stick together. That's what I've written down before I spoke to me and Brad. We know what we're talking. I need some points as well, I can assure you, after Silverstone, where nil points came my way. But I've gone for Jorge Martin as well, yeah. He's been on pole. He's won the race there as well. Okay. Come on, Greg. Let's have the truth.
I'm sorry. I've gone Bagnaia. I just think it's going to be... Well,
so
I knew you were going to do that. I've got to think about the points, though, Harris. I knew you were going to say that. I don't know. I just think it's a Ducati circuit. It looks like it's going to be dry, but it might not be. As we said, there's a few chances of rain. I know it's boring. Yeah, okay, fine. Brad, do you think KTM can still win this championship? Because I know the gaps are quite big. You're 83 points behind, but there's still over 400 points left on the table this year.
I'm not drooling myself out of this. I reckon I'm in for the fight. I'm up for it. And it's not over until it's over. So I'm going to keep my head down, keep focused, keep pushing. And, if we can get it right, fantastic. And if we can't, the closer we are, the better.
The sprint prediction then. Sprint prediction. Okay, Nick, you're all confident. You can tell us first.
You're not going to like this. I've gone for Bagnaia to win the sprint.
Oh, that's so boring. That's so boring. Unbelievable.
I knew you were going to. I've laid myself absolutely open to attack there, haven't I?
Yeah, very much have, and I will get in there. Well, I'm going to get this out of the way. I've gone for Bagnaia as well. I think he's going to win it from pole. I'd like to see some variety, but I just think that's what's going to happen. Mr. Binder, what do you reckon?
I think you two are cooked. I'm going for KTM at a KTM home GP.
Of course you
I'm
are.
I'm backing myself here.
Okay, let's make another prediction. This is the most positions gained, then we'll come to the winner. But who's going to gain the most positions between where they start on the grid and where they finish in the main race, the Grand Prix on Sunday? So I've gone for Miguel Oliveira. I'll kick this one off. Great win. He's good on that circuit, isn't he? But he hasn't had the best qualifying, usually in double digits so far for the RNF man. So I'll go for Oliveira. Brad, we'll go to you for this one. Who's going to gain the most positions? It's usually somebody who doesn't qualify very well, isn't it?
Well, I think if I have to go for somebody at the moment, I'll go for Augusto Fernandez. I think he's actually leading the positions gained over the whole season so far. So I think it'd be a pretty good good prediction.
I've gone. I've stuck my neck out. Probably not.
Zarco. Like, you always go.
No, I haven't gone.
No, we haven't.
I think Miguel Oliveira is actually quite a good choice. Fernandez is a good choice. I've gone for Aleix Espargaró after his ride at Silverstone. Thinking that it, but he probably will qualify a little bit better than to take that position. So it's probably the only points I'm going to get because I'm saying I think I've made a mistake.
Okay, what about some of the other manufacturers? Honda, Yamaha. What's going on there, Nick? I mean, how are they going to get themselves out of this hole they're in?
Cool. I think if I had the answer, I'd be flown to Japan and paid millions of pounds because obviously the situation is very, very tough. It's a situation, certainly since I've been involved in Grand Prix racing, I've never experienced before.
What's it like, Brad, as a KTM rider? Obviously, you're riding for KTM and you want KTM to win as much as possible, but I guess the more people in the mix, the better for the show. Is it a bit sad for you to see some of these guys struggling as they are?
It is sad to see riders like Mark, like Fabio, like really, really struggling, you know, because I mean they're world champions, they're amazing riders, and it's tough to see them struggle. So I can't imagine being them. It must be even more difficult.
Okay, prediction time. I'm going to get mine out of the way. This is for the Grand Prix win on Sunday, and I know Nick's going to make fun of me again, but he always does anyway. So what the hell? Listen, he started already. I'm going for Bagnaia. I'm going for Bagnaia again. I just think it's going to be
I'm
a pecker weekend. All right, Go on, Harris. Take it away.
I've gone from Brad Binder to win the race. After the ride at Silverstone, home Grand Prix, the ride he had there in 2021. And I think he'll find just that little bit extra. What was it? 0.7 seconds at Silverstone or a little bit less. And I think Brad will win the race for KTM and the place will go completely crazy.
Nick, we're going to have to make one
I'm
of those.
I'm a big Nick Harris fan. Yeah.
Can we get an icon of Nick doing that? Because Brad's going to say Nick Harris is going to win the race now, isn't he?
There you go. Well, I'll send you my bank account number.
There you go. I think I'm going to have to back Nick on that decision. I think you spoke some sense there, and I'm really looking forward to getting there, and I think we're in for a solid weekend. So again, I'm going to have to try and back myself on this one.
Okay, so just to confirm, Brad Binder's gone. Brad Binder, but you've got to, right? I mean, you'd probably be sacked, wouldn't you, if you didn't say that? I mean, you've got to believe in yourself.
Well, I don't know if they would sack me, but I would sack myself. So
good luck at the weekend. Yeah.
I appreciate it. Thank you so much for having me on the show again, guys.
Yeah,
thanks for having me. I'll be there, see you there.
Yeah.
All the
see
best.
You later.
Thank you. Cheers, guys.
Thanks, Brad. Bye-bye. All the best.
We'll be back for the Catalan Grand Prix predictions in a couple of weeks' time. But Alfie Desain, good luck for Austria. Not too much good luck to Nick Harris, though.